Hey there, creative minds. Welcome back to our YouTube channel, your go-to spot for all things data recovery. Today we are tackling a common yet very frustrating issue, the infamous scratch disk error in Photoshop. This error can really disrupt your workflow, but do not worry, as we have you covered with Recoverit. We will break down why this scratch disk error happens in the first place, and more importantly, how you can fix it. And also, we will show you how you can recover lost photos using Recoverit. Before we get into it, please make sure to hit that subscribe button and click on the notification bell so you won't miss any of our future tips and tricks. Also, if you find this video helpful, please make sure to leave a thumbs up on the video and also leave a comment below with any of your thoughts. Now, let's get to it. Alright, so we are kicking off by first understanding why the scratch disk error in Photoshop happens in the first place, before we even get into how to fix it. There are a few reasons. Reason number one, accumulation of temporary files. Every time you force close Photoshop without letting it shut down properly, it actually leaves behind some temporary files. And these files can quickly add up and hog your disk space. Imagine these files as crumbs left behind every time you eat a cookie. Over time, they build up and actually clutter your workspace. These temporary files are essentially unfinished tasks or unsaved work that Photoshop was holding onto. And if not properly cleared, they can actually take a significant amount of space in your disk. Reason number two, lack of space on the scratch disk drive. If your primary drive is running low on space, Photoshop cannot function efficiently and actually throws up this error. This is like trying to write a long essay on a piece of paper that's already filled with notes. There's simply no room left. The scratch disk acts as a temporary storage area for Photoshop to store any files it needs to access quickly. And if there's no storage left, it means that Photoshop cannot perform its tasks. Reason number three, fragmented disk space. Photoshop needs a large chunk of contiguous free space to work smoothly. So a fragmented drive can cause the scratch disk error because it can't simply find enough unfragmented space. Think of this like trying to find a big enough parking spot in a crowded lot. If there are too many small gaps, you simply cannot fit. Fragmentation occurs over time as files are written, rewritten, and deleted, causing free space to be scattered in small pieces across the drive. Now that we know why this happens, let's move into the fixes. Method number one, increase space. The simplest fix is to free up space on your Photoshop scratch disk. So we will give you a step-by-step guide on how to do it. Open Photoshop and go to the Edit menu at the top. This menu is your gateway to customizing Photoshop to better suit your needs. From the drop-down menu, select Preferences and then Scratch Disks. Preferences is where Photoshop keeps all of its behind-the-scenes settings. A new window will pop up, then select the drive or drives you want to use as your scratch space and click OK. By adding more space, you will give Photoshop the room it needs to operate smoothly. Think of this as clearing more workspace on your desk so you can spread out your project. Method number two, delete temporary files. Temporary files can pile up and give you the scratch disk error. Here's how you can delete them. Let's open File Explorer and navigate to Drive C, then select Users, then your username folder, then App Data, Local, and Temp. This temp folder is where a lot of these leftover files are stored. In the temp folder, look for files that start with /PST or Photoshop temp. Select and delete these files. By deleting Photoshop temporary files, you can free up a lot of space and prevent future errors. It's like taking out the trash. Important if you want to keep things clean and functional. Method number three, increase the RAM assigned to Photoshop. Photoshop uses 60% of your total RAM by default. So here's how you can give it an increase. Go to Edit, then Preferences, and click on Performance. This is where you can tweak how Photoshop uses your computer's resources. In the Performance menu, you will see a section called Memory Usage. Adjust the slider to increase the RAM allocation, and be careful not to give too much RAM as it may slow down your overall system's performance. This is like giving Photoshop a bigger slice of the pie, but make sure there's enough left for your system to function properly. Method number 4, adjust your scratch disks. Sometimes it helps to spread the load into multiple drives. So let's dive right into how you can do this.
Go to Preferences in the Edit menu and then select Scratch Disks. Check the boxes next to the drives you want to use and click OK. This way, you are not putting too much pressure on a single drive, which can help prevent the scratch disk from filling up. Think of this as spreading your workspace to give yourself more room to work comfortably.
Did you accidentally delete some important files while clearing the disk? No worries. We will show you how you can recover them with OneAssure Data Recovery.
Let's launch Recover It on your computer. This software is designed to recover lost, deleted, or inaccessible files from various storage devices. Then select a location under the Devices tab or the Desktop under the selected location tab and click Start. This tells Recover It where to look for your lost files. Choosing the right location increases the chances of recovering the files you need. Recover It will now begin scanning the selected location for lost files. It's like sending a search party to find your lost items. The scanning process may take some time, depending on the size of the drive and the number of files to be scanned. If you have large video files to recover, use the Advanced Video Recovery feature. This is a deeper search specifically for large video files. Advanced Video Recovery can piece together fragments of large files, ensuring that you will recover the full usable file. Once the scan is complete, review the files and select the ones you want to recover. Click on the Recover button. This step lets you see what you are getting back before you finalize the recovery. Reviewing the files helps you to verify their integrity and ensure you're recovering the right data. And just like that, your files are back safe and sound.
All right, so that wraps up today's tutorial on how to fix scratch disk error on Photoshop. We hope you found these tips helpful. And if you did, please give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and leave a comment below with any questions you might have and suggestions for future videos. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more recovery tips and tricks. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.